Hello.
Scheiße Wurst.
Welcome to the non-Greg Sterlis, Greg Sterlis show, except only the substitutes. I'm your host, the Pam Azan.
Hey, hi,
and
Pam.
We have some people here today. Let's see who comes up first on the marquee. Oh, ho!
Whatever, it's a secret.
The co-host, the Green Schwinn. Hello, Green Schwinn.
Hey, hi, it is great.
To be here.
It is wonderful.
As you probably knew, we are here.
You are here.
It is secret, Polish secret, I would not tell you.
America, you could play baseball or
in
football.
A park.
In the park?
Mostly football.
From 3 feet away.
If you feel like it, I don't care.
With a tuxedo on and six belts.
You could do that if you wish.
Got it.
Hey, and our musical guests. My rap name is Alex.
Hello.
Welcome to the non-Greg Stores, Greg Stores show for the second time. So you informed me that last time you were on, Jay Aquarius asked you a question. It was left on a cliffhanger. We can't have that.
It was the cliffhanger. I was thinking that we should start this show with, like, you know, to be continued. When we last left our heroes, they were...
Well, when we last left our heroes, they were in this much colder attic than it is now.
On the next episode of Greg Sterlis Show.
That was one of the first episodes I watched of this, was the one you were on. That was a good one.
Oh, cool.
Oh, there we go.
Yes.
It was great.
So his question to you was, I believe... What inspired you to rap, or who influenced you to rap, you know, the music question?
Yeah, he asked me what inspired me to rap, and I told him that George Bush becoming president inspired me to rap. And then he was like, no, but I mean, like, who are your musical influences? Which, fortunately, my musical influences just all joined one band, so, like, you can get them all in one place now. It's like that.
And who are they?
The Prophets of Rage. It's like Public Enemy and Rage Against Machine, both.
So nice.
Ridiculous.
Wunderbar.
Say that again. What's that name? The Prophets of Rage?
Yeah, Prophets of Rage.
Well, that sounds delightful. Shoot, I'm going to have to check that out. Delightful. So right. do you have any shows coming up? We'll get that right out of the way first.
I have but one show. And I fear that it is coming up so soon that by the time this goes to air. But on Saturday, I'm doing the Knowledge Fire Black Party for my friend Dave Harder, who used to be the drummer in my band Bloodthirsty Vegans.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. It'll be on
Bloodthirsty Vegans doesn't exist anymore?
They do, but their drummer is a different person. I all my life, I've had what's called like a sympathetic accent.
Yes.
And as soon as people start speaking in an accent, I have to do like everything in my power to like resist that accent.
No, I've done that too.
I agree.
Because sometimes, me and Andy go to like a lot of these Arab corner stores, and
he'll
be like, "Oh, this is great, bizarre, yes, it is." And but we go in there, wait for never not to do it. And then there's this British pork pie company near my house, and sometimes I accidentally start slipping into a British accent when I'm there, and it's like awkward. Mm.
I heard they have delightful food. Is that true?
Oh, it's some of the best ever.
Really?
It's really good there. You can eat there. Not only, it used to just be a little tiny one table where you could order the pie, but now it's like a full-on restaurant and a bar. And me and Andy are going to try and go there, see if they'll let us play. They'll always be in England there.
Oh.
That's what I might.
Yeah.
That would be
they're
fun.
Really nice people, too. They have like a baby, and they're really nice.
Yeah, I remember when I was working food service and people from the South came through and... I started to pick up their accent, and then I was like, I wonder if they noticed. So I tried to say something back with a full-on accent, and they did not notice.
Oh, wow.
They did not notice at all. So I was like, that's interesting.
Oh, can I just bring up one more thing, Pam? I last time we were on, I didn't realize you said you were a bowl puller, and I didn't realize
what?
That. You extract things from a bowl. You said you used to do that.
I watched the tape back, and I did not want to gloss over that. We were talking about the stuff that you put your hand in or whatever, and it like freezes.
No, my...
Stuff? Or whatever you put... Not your hand.
Well, I didn't put my hand... No, we had one, yet. But I didn't do it. I was too little. My dad
Oh, okay.
Did.
I thought you were the one...
Liquid nitrogen, and there
Dudley
was bull semen
me.
In there. And you had to take it out, and you let it thaw out, and then my dad would inseminate the lady cows.
Okay.
So it's frozen, if you hated someone, you could use it as an ice cube in some Crystal Pepsi.
Ew.
You could.
Okay.
You could do that. Yes, we would.
Yeah.
I would sometimes, we'd get my dad to pour it on like things that were like not normally things that would shatter, and then we'd shatter. He would have them shatter. Whoa. We'd have him shatter them, and we thought that was delightful.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Pure entertainment. I like to shoot dogs from the window.
No, I did not shoot any dogs from the window.
Yeah. I don't know. I did
have to corral a bull once by grabbing it, you know, in the nose because it was kicking and.
A full-grown one?
Yeah. Yes.
Whoa, that's kind of risky.
That's terrifying.
It was terrifying, but I mean, they will. We were in the pen trying to. I don't remember what we were doing, but you know, it started to act up and it came at us in a. They don't like that. They're like, yeah.
Was he like kind of familiar with you, the bull?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you remember his name by any chance?
I don't.
Because I would write a song about him.
Oh, I would love to.
His name. Sorry.
We got a new dog. Yeah. We named Freya. We wrote a song about her, but she's
Freya's
scary.
My song.
Yeah.
Have you spent any time on farms or?
Not a ton.
Not a ton.
Can I ask you, Alex, are you actually a vegan?
I am not a vegan, and in the Bloodthirsty Vegans, I think of the, like, 60 or so people who have been through the band, there are only, like, two that I know that have ever been vegan.
Oh, okay.
I am a vegetarian for the last 20-plus years.
Oh, okay.
Is the difference, like, vegans are more strict than vegetarians? Like, vegans can't eat, like, stuff that vegetarians still can't eat?
Yeah, vegans don't eat, like, honey or
cheese,
gelatin or
cheese milk,
or dairy, yeah.
Eggs.
Yep. And I eat, I just don't eat, meat.
Right, okay. Mm. Fair enough.
Yeah.
I'm not even really a fan of meat. It doesn't taste that good to me.
Yeah.
You're a vegetarian.
Last time I was on, we also did this same. We were like, does anybody ask, you know, the Doors if they're Doors, or does anybody ask the Beatles if they're Beatles? Like, we're just the Bloodthirsty Vegans.
For real. You know,
Christ.
Yeah, we're not even actually a bison.
Yeah.
I thought you were.
Well, I don't know. We might be like a transformer and don't know it. Like the world's lamest transformer. It just becomes a bike.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Shoot.
My favorite transformer was the one that became a cassette tape. I still have
however, Cassiophonic, just so you know.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means. Yeah. What is that?
Cassiophonic marching band. And I march.
But what does Cassiophonic mean?
If you don't know, I can't explain it to you. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
That sounds really high tech.
No, it's very low tech.
New technology.
Oh my God.
From David Liebe Hart.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
You know.
David.
Having
Liebe.
The delightful cast. Oh, here we go. I don't know if that has batteries. It might have batteries. Let's see. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. I think it does. Oh, here we go. This is the best Casio ever. Best Casio? That's
K1. One, not the two.
Because you can just say.
I would not tell you.
Hello?
I think the best thing about Casio's.
Wait.
Nice.
Cassiophonic.
Now I can hit autoplay and it'll play it back.
Cassiophonic. Cassiophonic. Cassiophonic.
Cassiophonic, yeah.
Can you look like you're overdubbing?
Yeah.
You can only do one sample at a time, though.
You can only do one word. But you just hold sample down, then you say your word, you hear dink.
Okay.
And there you go.
That's hot.
Yeah, I know. That was like.
I did not.
Let's see.
Okay, you gotta be quicker.
I did not.
Ding.
I did not.
Woo!
I did not.
You can move it too, so keep
climbing. I did not.
Love is blind. Love is blind. Oh, hi, Mark. Love is blind. Oh, hi, Mark. Denny. Oh, hi, Denny.
Yeah, if you see one of these, Alex, you should pick them up. They're so fun. They're really, really great.
That's totally tubular.
Yeah, and they have a little, So you can also, like, they have a little sequence, a little synthesizer in them where you can pick your envelope and
and now the four of us are all hooked on Cassiopeia.
Hey, hi, Winky Wonk.
Audience is Cassiophonics.
That's
shoot. I shouldn't show people that. Then everyone's going to be at the thrift store. You don't want one of these. They're terrible. If you see one, call me immediately and pass it by.
You're going to wait for them so they don't get tempted by how stupid it is.
they're terrible. You don't want one. Awful, awful. Yeah, this is like, yeah. Yeah, these are very fun.
SK1.
SK1, SK5, and SK60. Yeah. I have one of each. Well, I have like 5 or 6 or 7, maybe nice. 9 of these, but not a hoarder. They're backups. That's right. They're backups. They're backups.
What kind of keyboard you got there, Alex?
Yeah, that looks nice.
Have a little Corgi Air. Nice.
Corgi?
Yeah. It's
woof, woof.
I was thinking the same thing.
I like Korg keyboards as well.
Yeah, it's a Korg. I really, really super hard resisted ever getting like a wireless keyboard, but everybody was like, what? Yeah, you should get one of those Bluetooths. And I was like, well, I just saw, I don't trust it. And I always think, like, if you want like your shows to go flawlessly, you need to like plug the patch cable into the place where you plug it in, and then you can just rely on it. But then I got a Bluetooth just because people were nagging me. Now as soon, like the first time I like picked it up and like walked around doing stuff, then I was like, yeah, I see what you mean.
I've always liked that sticker. Where'd you get that made? That's cool. Huh? I've always liked that sticker on the back. That's cool.
Oh, this is not a sticker.
Oh, it's not?
What's that? A printout from my printer, which has got clear tape holding it on.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. It's like the next best thing to a sticker, but not.
Oh, it's even cooler than a sticker.
And that's your website, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I've been on their website. It's pretty nice.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a whole, like, huge array of websites that are all, like, completely untended gardens.
Oh, you've got more than one website for, like, your music?
My rap name is alex.com is mostly where I put my music. BloodthirstyVegans.com is a place also, but but no, I had like a sprawling empire of domain names and websites and stuff before I got into music. And as I've become a little poorer over time, I've had to like decide which ones to let go every year by year, but I still have like a core of some.
Oh, okay, cool.
Do you use one of those sites that's like it's got like a templates and stuff for you? We use this thing called Weebly. I don't know how to do it. This guy did it for us, but like, which domain or whatever do you use? I don't even know.
There's Weebly. There's Wix. There's a couple of them.
Wix.
Yeah, I use none of the above. I just sort of hand code them, which is.
Oh, you know how to code.
Yeah, I went to school for that.
That's nice.
Which has probably a lot to do with why they're all sort of untended and like withering on the vine of just sitting.
Because you'd be doing all the stuff yourself, so like.
Because I hand code them, and so like I used to just regard myself like I'm an old fashioned craftsman. I like everything you see on my website. I like made with my hand, like you know, every pixel by pixel. I like did all this. And then I became a parent, and having a child changes things about your concentration level.
Oh, I didn't even realize you had a kid.
Yes.
Oh, really? It changes your concentration level? Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, like once upon a time, I could be like on a coding binge for like 72 hours,
slamming down some
Cap'n Crunch or whatever, and just be like, and like holding on to like you know where. You know, 50 different variables used to go, and then now I can't really string like a solid 10 minutes together.
Kids will do that.
Captain Crunch sure is good though, especially I like the peanut butter stuff too.
Yeah. You got to watch them. They'll put anything in their mouth. That's what I discovered watching my nephews. Anything, mm-hmm. anything.
That was the
And if you try and get the stuff out, they mm-hmm. bite.
That's why they banned Kinder Surprise here. And I've always wanted to try Kinder Surprise, but the only country they don't sell it in is America.
What is it, Surprise?
You never heard of Kinder Surprise?
Surprise, no.
Yeah.
Is it German?
It is from Switzerland.
Oh, okay.
You can go across the border and get them.
Yeah,
you
know, I've thought about
not
it.
Not far.
I want to go
not
get
Not far.
One. Have you had one? Are they good?
It's just chocolate that's hollow with something inside it.
Oh, that's lame. I thought it was like super special. Everybody, all this
foreigners
talk about how good it is. I thought it was something amazing.
No, it's just chocolate, and it's a howl chocolate egg, and inside it is a toy.
Yeah, well, I still
that's
want
the
one.
Surprise.
That's the surprise.
Is the toy different, like, depending
yeah,
which one
yes.
you get? Oh, okay.
It's a surprise for the kinders.
I will discover your secrets.
But that period of time of, like, having to follow a toddler around was like the period in question of just like having absolutely no concentration, because like everything is like gets your spidey sense tingling.
Yeah.
Like every moment of the day you're just hyper alert. Now like my daughter's in school and now I can sort of slowly
do
start
some things,
getting back
yeah.
into
Does
it.
Does she like your music?
She likes music.
Good.
She likes me.
I'm not that great at math.
And then she like, but like, if I start playing music too long, then she just, just like pushes me out of the way and starts doing her own music.
Oh, she does her own music.
Yeah.
Cool. Cool.
Yeah.
Guys, I will not tell you.
That is cool. That is super cool.
Wunderbar.
Yeah.
Wunderbar, yes.
My little nieces used to go to the jamboree and sing with me.
Oh,
that
cool.
That was fun, yeah.
Nice.
I was surprised they were little and they did it. They stood up and then everyone was like, oh, tiny children.
Oh, my God.
Oh, they were actually very good,
oh,
though. They were on key and everything.
Oh,
but
yes.
But yeah, like, you know, the jamborees are people in their 70s and 80s, so they were just like in love with
just
my little nieces.
Up.
Yeah, they were eating it up.
Nice.
It was adorable.
Guys.
Like it was like, Kinder Surprise.
It was a Kinder Surprise for them. They didn't have
the
to eat any chocolate.
Surprise, yeah. What? I would, yeah.
Yeah, the jamborees in the country. Kind of
Where is
interesting.
It? Is it, what is that?
The ones I go to are in Livingston County, which is really far away. There's not much in Livingston County. Letchworth State Park is in Livingston County, if you've been there.
Oh, I've been there, yeah.
Yeah. And it's just like people show up and play old country songs, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, I remember.
Actually, he did Brand New Key. That's what he did, the Melanie song.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, that's what they sang.
I like our version of it. My mom thought it was super cool.
Yeah. They picked a nice hard song, so you'd have to jump octaves.
Oh, yeah, vocally. Like, the chorus is super easy, but vocally, that's a tough one.
Yeah, the chorus is tough, yeah. So do you want to play some music for us?
Let's do.
Sure, yeah.
Awesome. All right. So let's hear some of my rap name is Alex. Clop, 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 clop.
Short time ago, right around the block, a gang of old money frat boys got all juiced by the size of their stock portfolio. And they got all hopped up on sugar like the great Cornholio. From the halls of Montezuma, shores of Tripoli, to the reservation nation, to the penal colony. They divided the human family, made us to fight, and we're dumb enough to duke it out. That ain't right. Now we're excited, united. ready to resist, delighted to exist, rise like a fist, stand for solidarity, too strong to divide. It's time for all oppressed people in the one world tribe to get alive, start feeling the way the world could be, should be, would be, will be, you feel me? We try to feel free while civil liberties are rolled on the rail. It's a free country, that's what we say. Hey, but don't fear. But I stand up for others. I got a world full of brothers, sisters, others. The world over, surprise, now the uprise is global. I dare not to view World War II as good against evil. Evil is everywhere, and I see dead people. All the ghosts in Tokyo, so sorry that we hurt you. No out of our armor, fiber arms, a paragon of virtue. Reaper drones and Eurozones are rolling out the tanks, but we see MF loans. We smell the World Bank and it stank so bad the whole continents are still sad. Paying back aristocrats for crap they never had. Box at each scratching beaches bare for the silicone. So be Sky and NI, be hacks are in your telephone. Elites outrageous are your own with Fox News on. My dog's an angry dog, fire and brimstone. Clever cats spend all day just to see their words play. I just say what I see as I watch what I say all day on the hamster wheel. It just don't stop. Nope, fascism is here, it arrived with the drip, drip, drop. It's the people in our fate against the will of the state. And it's no great debate whether more war can wait. In time, we find that justifications for war ain't even true. Live and learn, that's what we say, but don't do. In time, we find that justifications for war ain't true. Live and learn, that's what we say, hey, but don't do. But I stand up for others. I got a world full of brothers, sisters, others. The world over, surprise, not an uprise. It's global. I said, I stand up for others. I got a world full of brothers, sisters, others. The world over, surprise, not an uprise. It's global. Like sandcastle palaces, flaming chalices, birds, bees, butterflies, trees, music, families, tribes, loving, listening, vibes, action, relaxation, rejuvenation, sensation, patience, love, communication, sun rays, moonbeams, abundance of green, beauty the light brings, the beauty the night brings. It's just a couple of my favorite things and the sounds of the scratch of the guitar string. I like smiles on baby faces, fun new places, rejecting rat races, cats in most cases, embraces, filled with sincerity, clarity, certain connotations of charity, sudden opportunity, helping a stranger, courage and face of danger, an outlet, bigger angle like grabbing a mic, doing it right, sunlight, at first light, and love at first sight, scenic summer walk, 4 days, street chalk, warming up winter, passion, pillow talk, kissing the cold nose, peeling off wet clothes. Anything I'm doing with you, I suppose. Rip, roaring fire, it grows from an embassy. Your smile is eternally etched in my memory. I like love, trust, truth, plus licking my lips, line with nerve endings, ending, pretending, starting, time spending, sending, telepathic care, learning to share, showing up, being there, yeah, clean air, raging waters, sons, daughters, failing, trying hard, having a good attitude at any latitude. My rap name is Alex, peace, love, gratitude. Peace, love, gratitude.
Hello.
Oh,
welcome back, everybody. Great job.
Wunderbar.
Yes, yes. So, so you did.
I just want to say,
yeah,
like,
go ahead.
Last time I was on 10 months ago, I did a version of Disseminated Information that ended up being the absolute best audio quality of any live thing that ever got recorded.
Oh, cool.
And I want so badly to like put it on a live album sometime and
do it.
Cost it on my SoundCloud.
Yeah,
it's just.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, absolutely do it.
I like a lot of stuff.
When I watched the show back, I was like, oh my God, Tom is a genius.
Right.
And Dudley's no slouch either.
No, Dudley knows his stuff. He's
extremely good sound engineer.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's pretty sharp, that guy.
I still don't know what tools he has in that pouch.
Mm. In his pouch.
I think he knows Professor Toothy because they both study like time travel.
Mm. Time travel. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, except I never saw Dudley feed anyone a lamb chop.
Yeah, that's true, but... Look at Professor Toothy if you don't know what that is.
I don't know what that is.
There's a whole novel based on it, and, like, it's good.
Well, that's good. How about you guys? You guys playing in time in the future?
Yes, we have a few shows coming up. I'd also like to plug, we have a new live album out called Live from Scutchville and a new collaboration project out called Slade and the Big Green Schwinn that we recorded out in Oregon. And it's really good. It features us and our dear friend Slade.
That one's not for kids.
It's definitely not for kids. Very, very, very...
Going. Oh, fuck yeah. That last take was really vulgar. We should do it again, and then the next take is way more vulgar. So he's like, oh, that's a keeper.
Oh, that's bad. Where's my Pokemon toy?
Yeah.
Well, you know, that's all right. I'm in a band called Anal Pudding, so I'm
that's true.
I can't judge.
But I highly recommend it. It's really funny. But what are our shows coming up?
I'm playing. Trying to check my little dossier here to find out.
I know we're playing with You Cunt on
the
30th.
Of October.
And then
we will be at the Hostel on October 19th with
Green
Gymnast, CC.
Yes.
We will be at Stamps on October 26th.
All over town.
As you probably already know.
Have you guys been to Stamps? Ever?
I've never been there, no.
Oh, have you been there?
I've never been there also.
I've heard of it.
It's interesting. It's interesting. I always have a very interesting time.
Nice.
Interesting in the that was weird way, which is okay, you know.
Sounds confusing.
That's probably why they're letting us play there.
Scheiße.
I liked playing there. I know this sounds crazy, but I felt like there were ghosts in the building and they were happy I was there. It was a very strange feeling.
I believe in ghosts. I'm convinced Shays is haunted. Shays is terrifying sometimes.
Shays is, yeah. Well, this place is kind of haunted, but they were happy. Oh. They were like, oh yeah, we like this ship. This is good. Absolutely nothing malfunctioned. Everybody worked. Everything worked perfectly. I was like, right. What?
If that's not an endorsement to come see us, nothing is.
Yeah. You ever been to ghosts on Iron Island over...
They do ghost things at Iron Island.
I used to do that all the time. Yeah, it's great over there.
But, oh, you guys aren't kidding. It's like actually haunted?
Yeah.
Iron Island?
On Iron Island, yeah.
Have you been to Iron Island? I've never
been
there.
It's over on...
I know they have like ghost hunters or something there.
Yeah, I used to do it all the time when I was like 18.
Yeah?
That sounds
it's
fun.
Really cool. But they were like...
It's almost Halloween. That sounds cool.
Lame, so I stopped going, but I still like the idea of seeing the ghost there.
Wunderbar. I've never been there.
It's cool. They do it all the time. I recommend anybody trying it if they can.
Oh,
it's free.
There we go.
Great.
We are done, right?